Hello everyone, welcome back to the Aspen Tech channel. And first of all, it is my great pleasure to announce you that I have completed my PhD studies from University of Engineering and Technology, Lahore, Pakistan, and now I am Dr. Mohammad Haris Humayun. So accordingly, I have modified the channel name to Aspen Tech channel / Dr. Mohammad Haris Humayun. So starting from here now, we will simulate crusher using Aspen Plus. And now we are shifting our focus to the solids handling in Aspen Plus. Recently, or in our previous studies, we have done the simulation of liquid and gaseous phases. But for the first time, we are now simulating the solids in Aspen Plus. So for the system, we have been given the feed specifications, which is conventional inert solid. So we will have to introduce obviously the solid in the process because the crusher system that includes the solids. Solid material is crushed and fine particles are produced in the system via crusher, jaw crusher, ball mill, and there are many examples in it. So we will today take Gyratory crusher in our example. And the temperature of the feed is 25 degrees centigrade, pressure is 1 atm or 1.01325 bar, mass flow rate is 1000 kg per hour, and the component, the solid component actually which we are taking is ammonium chloride NH4Cl. And populate PSD, which is particle size distribution using normal. So we will use the normal method for it. The standard deviation is 1 millimeter and D50 is 5 millimeter. Obviously, these are a few definitions which we will see once we go to the Aspen Plus. Then in particle size distribution classification, the mesh type is equidistant. We have to specify the upper bound and lower bound. So the upper bound is, or the upper limit is 5 millimeter, while the lower limit is 0 millimeter. With number of intervals as 10, if you remember our previous exercises for the classifications. Then the crusher type is Gyratory crusher and the maximum particle diameter is 2 millimeter. So let's quickly go to the Aspen Plus and simulate this. So what we need to do, first we need to click on this new and select solids with metric units for this, because first we need to always select the solids once we are dealing with the solids in the system, or we are doing the solids handling in the system. And after opening it, write it as NH4Cl. It is conventional, change it to solid, and going to the property package and selecting base method as solids and click on run. And once results are available, go to the simulation environment. And in simulation environment, what we need to do, we need to go to the solids tab. This is crusher and we are selecting this one as crusher as icon. And accordingly, we will do the connections over here, feed and product. So what we need to do, click on this material stream. This one is the feed of this process and this red one showing the product of this process, relabeling it. And this one is crusher, feed is entering and product is leaving. So clicking on this feed, and instead of specifying it mixed, which we have done previously, we will go to the CI solid and we will specify over here. This is the procedure of defining the solids in the Aspen Plus library. So 25 degrees centigrade, 1.01325 bar with a mass flow rate of 1000 kg per hour and with a mass fraction or mole fraction of 1 for NH4Cl. After that, we have to specify the particle size distribution, but the procedure is that we need to go to the setup in the solids, and in this PSD we have to specify the mesh type over here first, which is equidistant as we have selected. Number of intervals are 10, the lower limit is 0, the upper limit is 5, and this is millimeter. So we have to select the millimeter accordingly, and we have to then create the PSD mesh. And as you can see, 0.5, then 0.51, and accordingly 0 to 5 with an interval of 10 is selected. Then we need to come back to this feed, and accordingly we have to populate PSD using a user specified values or a distribution function. So what we need to do, select the distribution function. The type is normal. The standard deviation, as we have seen, is 1 millimeter, while for the D50 it is 5 millimeter. And clicking on this calculate, and once you click on this calculate, you can see this curve is generated, and the blue dot shows the discrete values for current mesh, and this is the continuous distribution function, so which is obviously in line with these. So after doing this, we need to go to this crusher, and accordingly in this crusher we need to first select the equipment. There are three types of it. Select equipment, determine outlet PSD, combination power and a distribution function, specify outlet PSD. So we are selecting the component for our system, equipment, which is Gyratory, and selection function, these are by default, so we will select it as it is, and the maximum particle diameter is 2 millimeter. And what we need to do, we need to click on this run, and once after running you will get your results available. And as you can see, the results are now available. So what we need to do, we need to go to these results to see, like, calculated power is this one, particle diameter which is larger than 80% of inlet mass, and converting all these to millimeter, because our overall system is dealing in millimeter. Like, we have specified the deviation, we have specified the upper limit and lower limits for the system, so all these are in millimeters. But what these actually reflect, so what we need to do, we need to go to this help of Aspen to understand what these values are, like the calculated power, the power required to crush the feed to the desired particle size, then particle diameter which is larger than 80% of inlet mass, that is the particle size which is greater than the particle size of 80% of the inlet, so above 80%, which is given over here, particle diameter which is larger than 80% of the outlet mass. So this one was for inlet, this one was for outlet. Similarly, for 50% for inlet and 50% for outlet is given over here. Then size reduction ratio 80%, ratio of 80% particle sizes in feed and product. Similarly, the size reduction ratio for 50%. Then shutter mean diameter of inlet, which reflects the diameter of spheres which would have the same volume to area ratio as the inlet particle mixture. For example, if V is the total volume of particles and A is their total surface area, then the diameter is calculated as 6V over A. And for outlet, diameter of spheres which would have the same volume to area ratio as outlet particle mixture. So we have calculated all these values, I can see from this crusher which we have selected. And if we have to look at the particle size distribution, you could see this is the particle size distribution across the system for the given system. Well, the blue line shows the feed and the green line shows the product for the system. So, and accordingly, going to the stream results, you can see that the obviously the there will be no pressure drop, there will be no temperature drop in the system idly. And clicking on the CIPSD to see the overall picture, because that is where we will get our required result. And this, in this PSD, you can see that 0 to 1 millimeter, then 2 millimeter, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and you can see that there is no particle above 5 millimeter. While initially, once we have specified the range from 0 to 10, there were different materials available over here, and now we have maximum in the range of 0 to 1 millimeter, then 2, few in 2, lesser in 3, and very least in the 4 millimeter range. So this is the overall working, or this is the overall simulation exercise for the crusher which we have done using Aspen Plus. Accordingly, you could vary crusher types like gyratory, single roll, multiple roll, cage mill, jaw crusher, cone, impact mill, hammer mill, ball mill, rod mill. There are various examples available over here which we will be doing our upcoming videos. So that's it from this lecture. Thank you so much. Please do watch, like, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Also click on the bell icon to get all updates related to this channel. Till then, it's goodbye. Stay tuned for more videos.